You're not your brain. Sorry, it's just a tool in your hands, okay? You're not your body. It's just the avatar you navigate the physical world with. It doesn't really matter if your body is annoyed today because it's not really you. Your ego is causing you a lot of pain. You're constantly trying to prove, just like you proved to mommy by taking your first step. You're a fully grown man or woman already, so stop trying to prove. And you're not the star of the movie. Seriously, the world is doing nothing to annoy you, okay? It's also not doing anything to please you. It's just rolling. So we'll take a break and we'll come back for more illusions. I got a very interesting question in the break, so I thought it would be good to cover it with everybody before we go back to the mainstream. Those who are more scientific, you'll be pleased to know that the next section is much more scientific, so no more weird spirituality from the Google X guy. But I zoomed through in the archery example. I mentioned that there were three levels of winning. There was pleasure, happiness, and joy. Remember that? So number three was the state of escape. Number two was the state of happiness, and number one was the state of joy. And it's really important to distinguish between those three, because in the West, in the advanced world, we really, really mix those up very, very clearly, very blurly. So pleasure is the sensations felt in your body that allow you to suspend your thought momentarily and accordingly reset yourself to your default state of happy. Okay? So once your brain stops thinking, your default state as a child was happy, so you go back to being happy. The easiest way to make your brain stop thinking is, you know, give it enough stimuli. Remember when we did the exercise of the stars? When you focus on something as intense as playing sports or as intense as dancing, or the sensations that you get in your body when you're working out or you're having sex or whatever that is, those switch off your brain. They get the brain to focus on that sensation and accordingly stop thinking. That state of pleasure has the drawback of the constant need to get more, because the minute the sensation goes away, your brain resets to the thinking, incessant thought mode, and it starts to bring new thoughts that get you either happy or unhappy, okay? And accordingly, what happens is that people tend to want more of their sensation, right? So you start first by, in my definition, I call that they use it as a painkiller. So they use pleasure as a painkiller. What does that mean? I'm unhappy, life is not making everything making a lot of sense to me. So what do? I go out and I work out and I dance and I say, na, 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 na. And so, you know, I reset after a while. I'm still unhappy because I haven't solved the happiness issue. Then I increase the dose. Okay? I may want to do more of that. I want to go to a wilder party, or maybe go do extreme sports so that I am on that kite surf and it's really risky, and right? And then with an extra dose, I manage to stop my brain again, okay? And then it comes back, and you know, you could go even further, go into drugs or alcohol, just anything that numbs that brain so that I find those moments of happiness. Using pleasure as a painkiller is the worst way you can use pleasure. But pleasure in itself is not a bad idea at all, okay? There are two uses for pleasure that I strongly recommend. One of them is to use it as a supplement, okay? When you're feeling happy already, okay, when things are okay, it's fabulous to go work out, it's fabulous to go dance, it's fabulous to feel, you know, to have a nice meal somewhere or whatever, right? Whatever gives you pleasure makes your brain not break out of that cycle of I'm okay, right? Just find healthy pleasures, pleasures that are good for you, good for your body, good for your health, and so on, right? I actually give myself a pleasure quota, believe it or not, businessman, right? So I measure the number of hours I listen to music every week. Music works miracles for me. I love music, right? And as long as I'm listening to enough music, my brain doesn't break out of the cycle. It continues to be in a good mood. The other way you can use pleasure is to use it as what I call an emergency switch. An emergency off switch is when your brain starts to attack you really, really hard. You can just flip that switch. What do? You close your door, you blast the music a little loud, you dance for a couple of, 20 minutes. You know, girls do that, we don't, but anyway, we listen to hard rock and we bang our head or whatever that is, right? And you completely suspend the suffering cycle, as I call it. You suspend that thought process that's making you suffer. The reason there is not in seeking the pleasure for its own. The reason is to suspend your thinking momentarily so that you can take control and then you can walk in and go through your thinking process from a good point, not from the bad cycle of the bad thoughts. Okay, so this is pleasure. As I said, we're not going to talk much about it, but it's important to think of pleasure as what it really is. It's a state of escape. It's not the target on its own. The states you're looking for are the state of happiness, which is, as per the happiness equation, when your brain agrees with the word. So happiness is really, you know, it starts from the brain. It starts from your thinking. When your thinking agrees with the word, you're happy. And that takes a lot of thinking and analysis and understanding of illusions and understanding of defects. But truly, when you get to that stage of, okay, I thought things through, I wasn't in a state of escape, and I saw things for what they really are, and I ended up being happy.